My dear Thomas, I am from India and the central province of India is called Madhya Pradesh. And there is a district, its name is Shivpuri. And in that district, there is a little village, its name is Behta. I born there in 7th August of 1944. My family is like the royal family. At that time, all the king and kingdoms, they merged into the Indian government. So my family shifted from there to Shivpuri. When I was little child of 2 years old, at that time, the many information came in my life. I have not seen aeroplane. I have not seen cell phone. About the religion, about the spirituality, about the philosophy, at that time I know the bell. When I got the admission in a school, my class teacher, his name was Pandit Saligramji Sharma. He was very fond of Vedas. One day I saw he was sitting and there is a book that was the Veda. And in that Raja, he was thinking. I was passing through there and I stopped and I started to watch. Sir, what you are doing? He told, I'm doing something, but you can't understand. Of course, but please let me know. Instead of that, whether I'm able to understand or not, try to understand, sir, please. Whether I know or not know, but what is happening with you, please let me know. And he told about the Richa, about the Veda. And with the bless of God, I solved his problem because I know everything at that time when I was the student of 4th standard. With this incident, he became very polite and always liked to give me respect, although he was my teacher and I was his student. And gradually, he always watched to me what I'm doing, how I'm sitting, how I moving, and one day he prayed for me, please, I want to become your disciple. Without any thinking, I said, yes, whatever you like, I will do. And he became my first disciple. When I was the 7th class student, my headmaster, Mr. Bhatteswar Dayal Srivastav, and there was a PT officer, Shankar Singh Pamar, and the drawing teacher, Mr. Nanneka. They became my disciple. Mr. Nanneka, he was Muslim. And he always feel that I am his peer. He asked me, I am very confused about the Yasin, Surat-e-Yasin. That is the heart of the Quran. And I explained it in a very proper, nice way. And he had a deep faith in me. So my journey of life was going in a very nice and smooth way. My mother, she was a very kind lady. At that time, after my school, I saw this people is hungry and I bring the food for the meal. And my mother and myself cook them and always feel he is the angel. God is coming with full of our heart. We like to serve them. And when I was the 17 years old, so a thought came in my mind, I must visit the Himalaya. At that time, there was not any newspaper or any source of knowing about the Himalaya. But that was an inspiration. I shared my thought about my mom and dad. I want to visit Himalaya. Without any objection, they told, yes, yes, yes. Whatever you like, you can go there. And I stayed there 8 months. Not for the spiritual work or anything. Just I want to stay there. Many things happened in my life like that. When I was the student of 6th standard, my mathematics teacher was Mr. Jain. He ordered to everybody then bring the mathematics book. I was also going to purchase the book, but middle of the way, there was a hospital. I saw a lady was crying there. A very lean and thin boy was in her lap. He's near to die. I asked her, what you are doing, what is happening? She told me, I don't know. I asked, where is your husband? He is going borrow some money from anywhere. Then I went inside and there was a nurse. I speak with her, please help this lady. And she told me, we have given a prescription, but they have not brought the injection. I brought the prescription paper and went to the chemist shop and bring the injection and gave to her. So I have just invest my money, which I was going to purchase the mathematics book. The second day, our mathematics teacher, he against asked, have you everybody the book? And if anybody had no book, then he can raise his hand and myself rise. And the same day, without any book, any teacher, they was writing on the blackboard. And what I say, it became remember into my mind. And what lecture they are delivering, I remember without any book. So from my sixth standard till my master degree, I have not purchased a book or notebook. Only in my examination, I bring the pen and pencil, whatever. Meanwhile, I met when I was maybe 9, 10 or 12. There was a great saint, Swami Ramgir Maharaj. I went to his ashram and thought in my mind, really he is real saint, real saint. And automatically, I became inspired from my inner side and agreed to bow down in his feet. And he called me and he accepted me as I am his disciple. I stay with him 31 years, but at 28 years, we have never talked. My guru and myself sit some away. And last time, after 28 years, he wrote a letter to me and gives man who was coming to Shupri, he instructs, please give this letter to me. And he wrote in his letter, the devotee, when he find a real guru, he feel the bless, but I found you as my disciple. I'm feeling the bless and gratefulness. That was more than sufficient for me. Although 31 years we live, sometimes I stay in ashram for 10 days, sometimes 15 days, sometimes 2 days. But meanwhile, we have not talked a single word. I have not asked anything, and he's not tell anything to me. I used to keep silent. I think in my mind, he loved me. But other people, when they saw this type of behavior of the guru, they start to making their distance with me because guru is avoiding me. Guru, he doesn't not like me, but instead of that, I'm coming again and again, again and again. But when he wrote this letter, everybody to see that letter and become stuck. In my life, I met with so many must and paramans. Meanwhile, I have got married. I have 2 children, my daughter and my son. And many parents, they gave their kids to me. And there is 41 kids. They are living with me as my family, as my son or daughter. Some of them I have married. In one girl, I have married in New Jersey and second Jabalpur and somewhere like that. And their education. One girl I sent to get the education in UK. And one she got the MPhil from Patiala. And one was, she was the Asian champion in powerlifting, Uma Patel. And now she got the selected as a district sport officer. Meanwhile, although at that time, when I was 11 or 12 years old, I have heard the name of Meher Baba, Avatar of the Ace. At that time, I know. I have a great respect to him. But I went, when he dropped his body, I visited his samadhi. And when I entered where his body kept, I bowed down there. And I found that Meher Baba, he caused me tightly. And I forget, he has dropped his body. I completely forget. Because Meher Baba is hugging me tightly. And when I came outside, I brought one rose flower. And the intention was that I will touch this flower to Meher Baba Samadhi and I will bring with me. But when he tightly hugged me, it became the crest. So again, I brought another flower and tried to enter. But there was a huge long queue. And the volunteer, he told me, please, you have came just before that. And now why you are entering there? I told, please, Meher Baba, he hugged me. So my flower became completely crushed. So I want to touch again. Please allow me. He told, Meher Baba, he hugged you? Yes. And he hugged me tightly. And you see, my flower, it became completely crushed. Where is Meher Baba? I saw there was not Meher Baba. But just I saw there is a picture. Meher Baba's picture in his samadhi. In that picture, he is putting a white kurta, and the same place, there was the color of the rose flower also, which was with me and which was also there. I told him, see that. So this was the God lived with me. And that is beyond the words. I have made a foundation, its name is World Spiritual Foundation. Through that, we have started to give some service for the creation, not only for mankind or animals, plant, but for the creation. I give the Shakti path in my presence, it's happened automatically. And Kundalini start to activate. So my message and my prayer for everybody, do the best. Be honest with yourself. Be kind. Have a love for everybody.